Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square for the recitation of the Sunday Angelus with Pope Francis. Today, the 22nd of January, as we celebrate the third Sunday of Ordinary Time. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome you to this broadcast. And some of you may be joining us through various channels associated with Vatican Media, such as the Vatican Audio Live Events app, the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News website, or the Vatican News English YouTube channel or Facebook live feed. To all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV India, Atmadarshan TV, Luminous Radio, as well as other radio stations and internet sites located around the world, a very warm welcome to you all. My name is Ben Sinclair, and it's a pleasure for me to provide the English language commentary for you during today's Angelus. And during Mass from St. Peter's Basilica this morning, the Holy Father instituted three new lay lectors and seven new lay catechists. These 10 men and women were originated from Italy, the Democratic Republic of Congo, the Philippines, Mexico and Wales, and they were specifically chosen because as a representation of the people of God present all around the world. The third Sunday of Ordinary Time, which we celebrate today, is also the Sunday of the Word of God, and this was instituted by Pope Francis in 2019 in order to highlight the necessity for every Christian man and woman to regularly spend time reading and praying with the Holy Scriptures, which are of course the Word of God. It allows the Christian to remind himself or herself of the presence of the Lord in their life. We see now the many faithful who've been gathered today on this cold and cloudy morning in Rome, many of whom will have been to the Mass in the Basilica beforehand, where there were roughly 5,000 men and women and children who were taking part in the Mass with the Holy Father this morning. We see there that there are, as well as the men and women, there are also many groups of children and young people who are at the who are on St. Peter's Square this morning. And in order to prepare people for the World Youth Day, which will take place later on this year in Lisbon, in Portugal, the Pope has sent a video message addressed to the young people who are preparing to take part in that event. The Pope said that the young people's desire to visit Portugal for World Youth Day fills him with a great sense of joy, and he encouraged the participants to open their hearts to those whom we will meet, adding that the World Youth Day offers young people a chance to expand their horizons and to look beyond. The large number of people who are here present this morning are awaiting the arrival of the Holy Father, which he will be doing so imminently, as they prepare to hear his Sunday message and pray with him on this Sunday. And here we see now the arrival of Pope Francis at the window of the Apostolic Palace, and we will begin shortly his Sunday Angelus address.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno.
Oggi il Vangelo della liturgia.
The Gospel from today's liturgy narrates the call of the first disciples who, along the Lake of Galilee, leave everything to follow Jesus. He had already met some of them, thanks to John the Baptist, and God had placed the seed of faith within them. And now, he returns. Jesus returns to look for them, where they live and work. The Lord always looks for us. He's always close to us, always. And this time he extends a direct call to them, follow me. And they immediately left their nets and followed him. Let's take a moment to reflect on this scene. It's the moment of a decisive encounter with Jesus, one they would remember for their whole lives and would be included in the Gospel. From then on, they follow Jesus, and in order to follow him, they leave. To leave so as to follow, and it's always like this with Jesus. With Jesus, it's always like this. It can begin in some way with a sense of attraction, perhaps due to others, then the awareness can become more personal and can kindle a light in the heart. It becomes something beautiful to share. You know, that passage from the Gospel struck me. That service opportunity had struck me. And this is what happened with the first disciples. But sooner or later, the moment comes in which it's necessary to leave so as to follow. And it's when it's necessary to make a decision. Shall I leave behind some certainties and embark on a new adventure? Or shall I remain where I am? This is a decisive moment for every Christian, because the meaning of everything else is at stake here. The encounter with Jesus, and then something happens. Let my egoism go. Shall I let it go, or shall I let it remain in me? If someone does not find the courage to set out on the journey, the risk is to remain a spectator of one's own existence and to live the faith halfway. To stay with Jesus, therefore, requires the courage to leave, to put us on the way. To leave what? What should we leave? Certainly our vices and our sins, which are like anchors that hold us at bay and prevent us from setting sail.
Per cominciare a lasciare è giusto che incominciamo a chiedere perdono.
It's also necessary to ask for forgiveness so that we can go further ahead. But it's also necessary to leave behind what holds us back from living fully. For example, leaving fear, selfish calculations, leaving the guarantees that come from staying safe. It also means giving up the time wasted on so many useless things. It's great leaving those things behind to live. How beautiful it would be to all leave all of this to experience, for example, the tiring but rewarding risk of service, or to dedicate time to prayer so as to grow in friendship with the Lord. I'm also thinking of a young family who leaves behind a quiet life to open themselves up to the unforeseen and beautiful adventure of motherhood and fatherhood. Leaving something but in order to start a beautiful adventure. It is a sacrifice, but all it takes is to take one look at a child to understand it was the right choice to leave behind these certain rhythms and comforts. I'm also thinking of certain professions, for example, that of a doctor or a health worker, who give up a lot of free time to study and prepare themselves, and who do good, dedicating many hours during the day and the night, and spend so much physical and mental energy for the sick. I think of the workers who leave the community to bring bread to homes. In short, to live life, we need to accept the challenge to leave. To accept the challenge to leave. Jesus invites each of us to do this today. So I leave you with a question about this. First of all, can I remember a strong moment in which I have already encountered Jesus? Let's think of our own story. In our life, has there been a strong moment when we've met Jesus? And is there something beautiful and significant that has happened in my life, due to which I left other less important things? And today, is there something Jesus is calling me to give up? What are the material things, ways of thinking, attitudes I need to leave behind to say yes to Him, yes, Jesus? May Mary help us to respond with a total yes to God, like she did, to know what to leave behind so as to follow Him better. Let's not have fear to follow Jesus, because by following Him we'll find something better.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Udine efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo nunciante, Christi Filii tui, incarnazione coniovium, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeterna dona eis Domine.
Lux perpetua lucet eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomine Domine benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, this third Sunday of Ordinary Time is dedicated in a special way to the Word of God. Let us rediscover with wonder the fact that God speaks to us, particularly in the Holy Scriptures. Let us read and study them, pray with them. Every day, let us read a section of the Bible, especially a Gospel, because here Jesus speaks to us and directs us, something that I've said before. Let's have a small book of the Gospels and put it in a bag so it's always with us. And at some point during the day, read a little bit of the Gospel, because Jesus accompanies us. A little Gospel book. So always have it with us. Today, in a special way, I give a special greeting and gift of peace to those in the Far East who are celebrating Lunar New Year. The Holy Father's expressing his will and his gift to those who are celebrating Chinese New Year, especially those who suffered because of the pandemic. And finally, the Holy Father
tradizionalmente riuniti possano sempre permeare e caratterizzare I nostri rapporti familiari.
Is asking for those who an improvement in the family and life of family life, and he wishes them a happy new year.
Il mio pensiero va in particolare a mia madre.
I look on with worry about the situation in Myanmar. One of the most old cultures in that country. I am close to the people and the societies which are under threat. May God finish quickly this conflict and let us pray together to Our Lady for Myanmar, and we pray together the Hail Mary for those in Myanmar who are suffering.
Santa Maria, Madre di Dio, prega per noi peccatori, adesso e nell'ora della nostra morte. Amen.
Anche invito a pregare perché c'è.
Also, I invite you to pray for those who are suffering acts of violence in Peru. Violence takes away the possibility of hope. In full respect of those who are fighting between brothers of the same country, I say no to violence, no more deaths. There are some Peruvian people in the square who the Holy Father greets. I see some positive solutions which are taking place in Cameroon to the violence which is taking place there. May those who are looking for peace and security be encouraged by what's going on. I send my greeting to those who come from Italy and from Italy and other countries. He's greeting those from Poland who were there in the square today, as well as all of those from Spain and various parts of Italy. A school group, those from the young group in Rome, as well as the Catholic Action. In these few days, we pray for the unity of Christians. Let us not never forget to invoke peace for the martyrs of Ukraine. May the Lord comfort and sustain those who are suffering greatly. I wish you a happy Sunday, especially the men and boys and girls from the Immaculate, and please do not forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch and goodbye. And as we now see the Holy Father greeting those present in St. Peter's Square as he makes his way back into the Apostolic Palace, we now conclude the live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis in St. Peter's Square on this third Sunday of Ordinary Time, the Sunday of the Word of God. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Mass, as well as other Vatican and world news. We'll be live back again on Wednesday morning from 8:55 a.m. Rome time, when the Pope will give his weekly general audience from the Paul VI Audience Hall. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank all the technicians who made this broadcast possible, and to all of you joining us, especially through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV India, Atma Darshan TV, and Luminous Radio India. And I wish you a very good rest of your Sunday. Praised be Jesus Christ. Laudato Jesus Christus.